Welcome back to my channel. Oh, wait a minute. I just saw a big mosquito sitting on my plant. What are you doing there? Well, okay. Excuse me. Sort of a grasshopper thing. Anyway, it's been a long time. I'm good, I'm fine. Today I am gonna do a little video with candles, bending candles. For me it was a kind of a new thing to bend candles in hot water. But it's apparently it's all over YouTube and TikTok. But for me it's a new thing. We're gonna use this container and fill it with hot water, and afterwards we're gonna put the candles in and let them stay there for about 15 minutes, and then I'm gonna try and bend it in funny shapes. Let's see how it goes. I'm not 100% sure that the candles are the right length, but it was the best I could find close to where I live. So, and I hope you've been doing good. I don't know. I didn't feel like filming for the last couple of months. Not sure why. But here I am, and thank you for being with me. It's the hottest water, hottest tap water, and obviously this is just for the beauty of it all, because it would be easier to just fill it with hot water. But I found this pretty glass. Call it an English glass. I don't know. Whatever. And, no idea if this is gonna be a success or not. We're just gonna try, and I will leave them in here for, I think 15 minutes will be better. Yes. I've heard that, or seen that it's better to use 100% paraffin or stearin, yeah, because if you use other kind of candles, I take it like wax candles, it will break easier. I don't know if that is true or not. See that little critter? Yeah. So it's you. It's you who have been eating my plant. Look at that. Bad little grasshopper. Okay. it stay there. The grasshopper also has to eat. But I think I'm gonna close the camera now, and then I'll get back to you in about 10-12 minutes. Welcome back. It's gonna be interesting to see if they will bend. Close up than looking at me. So look. Oh my god. They do feel kind of soft. Okay. I'm gonna try and bend the first candle now. Let's see how that goes. This one. Oh, I've seen so many candles break in the do-it-yourself videos. So which shape am I gonna do? I think I'm gonna do kind of a snake thing. Let's see. Wow, they're really bendy. Look, I just think the candle, look, it's not even breaking. Perhaps I should do it inside the water. You see? This shape. Look! I had no idea you could do this, but why not? You see? And then I know you should scrape a bit here because to make it a bit more flat, you know, when you put it like this. Perhaps I could just press it a bit. Okay. Yay! Let's see how long it'll stand. You see, it's actually still bending. Oh no. In the other direction. You have to stay there. Okay then. That was sort of successful. So, let's see. This is funny, guys. You should try and do that yourself. Let me think of another shape. See? I kind of made it a bit flat here. I think we have to, you know, this is enough. Look. Yeah, it's a bit better. Then perhaps a little bit here. Okay, let's see. Yay! It's working, guys. Okay. So, what I want to do now is use this bottle to make one of them flat and then kind of twirl it. I think I can do that. Here. Oh my god. Yeah. Look. They do get really soft and bendy when you put them, when you soak them in hot water. Look, isn't this funny? All flat. Let's see if I know how to do this. Uh-oh. Oh. To be honest, I think this candle is too short. You see? Maybe, or maybe it'll turn out all right. Look, isn't it pretty?
Yes.
It's funny. And then, I think that's it. That's it for this one. Only one, two and a half twirls. It is a pretty little light green candle. I'm gonna put it here. Continue to the next one. Yeah. I want to make a round circle. So, as you can imagine, this candle won't burn for long. Like, how much is that? 8, 9, 10 centimeters? Centimeter. Look, isn't that cute? Yep. This is a real snake. White snake. Look, isn't it funny? So, okay. I have two candles left. Pretty sure you guys have already come up with a shape in your head, in your heads. I did the S, I did the snake thing, and I did the twirl. So see, it becomes quite flat here. A little bit flat. Perhaps I don't even have to use the kitchen tool. Stable, but it's there. So you guys, I recommend doing these funny things, shapes with candles. You know, I would recommend that you buy candles that are colored all the way through. At least I had luck with these ones. I think they are paraffin. I'm not sure it's a good idea to buy those candles, you know, that are covered with a color only on the outside, and then perhaps some cheap mass inside. Anyway, paraffin, stearin. I don't know what this is. I'm not sure it's paraffin. Perhaps it's... Anyway, look. And what is paraffin and stearin candles anyway? What is that kind of material? I don't even know. It's getting kind of hard now, the shape. So, I guess this one is cute. You see, this is mostly for the fun of it, because it broke. It did break a bit, but it's not that much. A little bit here. The snake. Hello, little snake. And you see? It actually doesn't look that homemade or home. Oh God, home twirled, because look, looks one of those candles that you can buy in a shop. So here they are. I'm gonna put them on a display now, so we can enjoy these beautiful candles. Okay? Of course, they're still full of water. I kind of forgot that. Thank you. this table is not very, very valuable. It's dripping. It's dripping. So, look at this one. Don't give up. Stay and fight. Thousand candles can be lit from a single candle. Happiness never decreases from being shared. We did it, you guys. Look at those five beautiful flames. Fire.